Hi there, Dreamers. It's me, Jacqueline. If you are new around here, hello, welcome to my channel. Otherwise, welcome back. If you do enjoy what you see, I hope you consider subscribing. I generally center my channel on houseplants and particularly Hoyas, though today we are doing a slight departure from that. Before Hoyas, as I mentioned in my last video, I was obsessed with Peperomia, so today I thought I would give you a little tour of my Peperomia collection. If you enjoy this type of video, please leave me a like down below. I greatly appreciate that. If I have a Peperomia that is on your wish list, or if there is something I should be adding to mine, please let me know in that comment section down below. I love hearing from you. If you see me looking down, that's because I have a notepad on my lap with all my different varieties of Peperomia, so I'm gonna be referencing that throughout this video. The first Peperomia that I ever purchased was a Peperomia caparata. And because it wasn't labeled what color it was and I had to do my own research, I'm going to call it a raspberry ripple. That may not be correct, and that's okay. I loved this Peperomia so much that I ended up getting several other colors. I now also own the silver ripple Peperomia as well as the green ripple. The caparata texture is just this beautiful quilted leaf, which if you have pets will inevitably collect hair. It's still just one of the most beautiful textures to look at. It's very delicate and they are prone to overwatering, so they are definitely one of the plants that influenced me to buy a moisture meter so that I was not going to be drowning anything. The next plant that came to mind was my Peperomia obtusifolia. The one I have is variegated, and this one I actually bought in a 6-inch pot. I divided the plant in half after I moved and I ended up giving part of it away. I do like this plant, but it is not my favorite Peperomia by any means, and it's just gotten really large. It is a very prolific grower. I have it seated near a window, and while it doesn't get any direct sun, it's still putting off the most enormous leaves that are more variegated than the ones I bought it with, so I think it's pretty happy. It's hard to argue with a plant that's happy, even if it's not my favorite. The next one that came to mind is Peperomia serpens. This one I bought in an 8-inch basket at a big box store in my last living location. It's so cute. It's less quilted than the caparata, but it still just kind of looks like little floating heart pillows on a vine, and I think it's beautiful. It does flower for me pretty often. Peperomia do the little rat tail inflorescences, I believe is their technical term. An inflorescence refers to multiple flowers, supposedly, which is what happens on that little stick that they put out. Peperomia serpens has been a really prolific grower for me. I've propagated it quite a bit. I've given it to friends. The next one that comes to mind was featured in my last video, and that is my Peperomia rosso. And this one suffered a lot when I moved. I actually just repotted it yesterday or the day before into a smaller terracotta pot. I just kept digging and digging and digging because I didn't see any roots, and I realized that it was in a very small, one of those net pots that looks like it's going to dissolve away, but it never did. I ripped that out and repotted it, so hopefully the roots have it. Chance to expand beyond a 1-inch diameter. It was a very full 4-inch pot when I bought it. As it turns out, its root system never expanded beyond that 1-inch diameter, so hopefully it has a chance at life now. If not, there are plenty more where that came from. Apparently that's one of the few plants that my Home Depot stocks. I purchased a Peperomia San Marino, which is very similar to the Rosso. It's just the more silver topped as opposed to the green topped. They both kind of have the red bottom thing. It's pretty happy. It's very, very full. I haven't repotted it. It's still in the nursery pot it came in. Bottom water it because I literally can't get any water through the foliage with its fullness level. It's cute. I haven't had it that long, so I don't have very much to say about it. The next Peperomia is my Peperomia Hope. This one did suffer a little bit of sun damage on the day of my move, as I talked about in my previous video. But this one has grown a lot for me since then. It is really trailing now. It is starting to grab onto other plants. It's really an active grower for me, and I have hope that it will be full again. It is probably the Peperomia that most resembles a Hoya. It's got very thick, succulent-y leaves, and if you look at them a certain way, they're almost kind of translucent. It reminds me of the Peperomia prostrata, which I guess we can talk about next. The Peperomia prostrata, or string of turtles, is something that I was lucky enough to stumble upon in a big box store. When I found it, it was in the same pot I have it in now. It was a lot fuller before I moved. These guys are a little temperamental. I actually found two of them, and I bought one for me and one for a friend, and she loves hers too. Hers is doing really well. She's thinking of propagating hers. I've propagated mine quite a bit. It's been a really healthy grower for me. It's funny because most people say it's very difficult for them. And since I got mine as an established plant, I guess, it's been a lot easier for me. But it does like to dry out more so than it likes to remain moist. So just bear that in mind. It is semi-succulent. Parallel Peperomia, or the Peperomia pudiolata. This one is also nicknamed the stilt peperomia. It grows rather tall before it kind of falls over and trails. I think it's really cute. It has little pinstriped leaves that eventually, when they harden off, become kind of like cardboard, pretty rigid. It was one that I found at a nursery where I used to live and potted a couple of them together, and it's taken quite a while, but it's basically doubled in size. So I'm very happy with that plant. It's really cute. And it doesn't take up a lot of space. That's the nice thing about Peperomia, is they're very petite. Really can keep your collection pretty small and have a large amount of Peperomia, so that's kind of why they're an easy thing to collect. Peperomia beetle, or Peperomia angulata, which is one that I acquired shortly after moving here. There are only a couple of nurseries where I live now that actually carry many houseplants, and this I bought at one of them. It was flowering a lot when I bought it. It is now moved on from flowering to just putting off new growth, which I really appreciate. Responding well to a haircut earns a brownie point in my book. I love that about a plant. Again, haven't had it that long, so I don't have that much to say about it other than it's really cute and I enjoy the leaves. Peperomia number 10. Yeah, if you can believe it, we're already there. Peperomia glabella is what I believe this peperomia to be. It was sold to me as an unidentified peperomia. No one in the nursery knew what it was. And I was so excited to find something that no one knew what it was, and I didn't know what it was. So I immediately purchased it. It does really, really well. It's seated in a shelf that has a grow light in my home. It puts off really cute veining and kind of reddish tone on its new leaves. It is, I believe, going to trail. It's starting to kind of get to that point where it's getting flimsy because it's grown tall enough. Any day now, it's just going to give up, and I know it. I have trimmed it just in a couple of places, and it's put off a lot of new shoots from underneath the soil, which I think is really great. Not all peperomia do that as readily as others, so that was cool to see. Okay, next is the Peperomia watermelon, or the Peperomia argyria. This one, again, is fairly new to my care. I bought this one online. It is doing really well. I cut off a couple of the older leaves, and I am trying to propagate them. It has really set off a lot of new growth since being in my care. It's seeded under a grow light, along with a lot of other Peperomia, and rapidly multiplying day after day. It's put off a lot of pretty new leaves, larger ones than it arrived with. And what's nice is that a lot of the leaves it arrived with are really, really cup-like. And the new ones that it's putting off, even though they haven't hardened off yet, don't appear to be doing that same pattern. I'm happy with that. I'm not sure what variable I can narrow that down to, but it's a happy thing nonetheless. The Peperomia mini watermelon, or the Peperomia verschefeltii. No wonder this one has a more common name. This is kind of a miniature version of the Peperomia watermelon, but they're kind of different. It's still really cute. I found this one when I was looking for the watermelon, and I was still happy to grow my Peperomia collection. It's been a happy grower for me. It again loves bright light and has been rapidly multiplying and happily filling out its pot. Peperomia piccolobanda. This one is a little bit more unique. This dark, dark veining and very heart-shaped leaves, in my experience. At least on my plant, it's very heart-shaped leaves, so I enjoy that. I think it's really cute. Mine came in two little 2-inch pots. Once it was established, I combined them, and it has since grown quite a bit. It arrived with a lot of flowers. It's turned into a lot of new growth. Overall, I'm very happy with it in the short amount of time that I've had it. I was also able to find, alongside the San Marinos in my local big box store, a Peperomia Frost that was incredibly full and happy, and I just had to bring it home. My Peperomia Frost suffered a lot of sunburn when I moved. That was one of my favorite Peperomias, and I couldn't live without it. So when I saw this one, super healthy and full for like $5, I jumped at the opportunity. This one has done a lot of blooming. I'm not a fan of the blooms on this one, so I've just kind of chopped them off. But it keeps sending them out regardless. It seems pretty happy. It is a cluster of plants, don't get me wrong. Most of the plants sold in big box stores as Peperomias are clusters of like 10, 20 plants in a pot. Essentially, it lost some of its silver coloring when it lost some of the light it needed. So just be aware that some of the fun things about these Peperomias start to decline if you're not giving them the ideal care. One of the biggest Peperomias in my collection is the Peperomia polybotrya, or the Peperomia raindrop. I think it's also called Peperomia owl eye. That one I've heard the least, but it's semi-heart shaped and has a big dimple where it meets the stem or the petiole of the leaf. It's really, really pretty. It grows in a very unusual way. It grows almost like a tree and then puts out floating gigantic leaves, and it's kind of wonky, but I think that's kind of why I like it. That one's been a pretty fast grower for me. I have broken off a couple of the leaves that were like deformed. It will get deformed leaves. It almost look like a rash on the leaves. It's all bumpy and weird. If it's given water with too many minerals or water with too many contaminants in it, my plants do receive filtered water. I want to say almost all of them do. That one is one that I definitely make sure not to give tap water to because it will deform the leaves that it's making, which I find really interesting. This one is not my proudest moment. It's currently...
Girl, she did!
And that is my Peperomia Ruby Cascade. This one I just can't keep happy in my home. This is my second one to bite the dust, and I think I'm giving up. I come across them occasionally in big box stores, and I'm like, ooh, let's try again, and I think I'm done. I think I'm done with this one. It just isn't happy, and I'm not the most comfortable repotting this delicate of a Peperomia. If I were to tell myself the last time I bought it what I should do, that is come home and take it out of that soil and put it in something else. But I don't think I want to go down that road again. I don't think I want to risk killing it a third time. I just don't want that in my brain. My last Peperomia I almost forgot about because I have it with my succulents and my one cactus because it prefers a much more dry environment and it is very succulent, and that is a Peperomia kimnachii. I saw this one on Summer Rain Oaks' video in 365 Days of Plants, and I was, again, obsessed with Peperomia and wanted something different. So when I came across this in a nursery, I snatched it up immediately. It basically was a statue for the first 3-4 months of me owning it, and it has recently put off several leaves and has started growing. It's really happy underneath the grow light. It changes color a lot as it grows. Once it matures, the stem changes to like a lime green from a red, so I'm excited to watch that happen on the new growth. It's been a really fun plant to watch grow. That wraps up my Peperomia collection. Thank you so much. If you enjoyed this video, please leave me a like down below. Consider subscribing if you have not already, and I really hope to see you in my next one. Bye.